Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes Song of the Ocean Blind. This is the way to Selbart. We were originally going to go to the south, Enid. But now he wants to go to Selbart, but I think we need to go to Enid first. It'll let us go this way. Interesting. But I've been following a walkthrough for the purposes of getting the books. Only for that. I haven't been peeking at anything else. And there are two books in Enid that we must find. If we go to Selbart first and then go to Enid. Look at that, the footprints disappearing. Right, then Fred 9, which were, Fred Volume 9 is not going to be there. So we have to go get Fred Volume 9 and the other book. Which I think will still be there, but... I've never been down here, right? Running into things again. Anything? Just checking for any other passages that might have a cool chest or something. Got all flat. Thing looks very flat. Oh, not another tuning fork. Maybe on the way back. I was wondering. If there's things we can break apart with a McBain special rock fist thing, but that doesn't seem to come up very often. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. Oh, we'll fight this thing then. Sand tart and breakneck really? Breakneck cactus? Well, let's get sand tart B, I suppose. Remember, short controlled bursts. Good. I like when they go down with one hit. So keep attacking that. Saving the finishing moves. Now we can focus on the Brokeback Mountain cactus. Missed. Missed? What the hell? How rude. Very rude. Die. Punch him. There you go. A little bit of XP for that. Okay, continuing on our way. Oh, nice. Orb of Ocean 32. Nothing different in particular. A marble with an image of Slade shouting. Fascinating. Enid, yay! Uh-oh. They got the drums out. Picturing the soldiers of Numerous Army coming with like a drummer as like the last one in line behind them. Numerous Soldier says, the port of Enid is currently blockaded by the Numerous Army, so it's off limits now. McBain says, well, no point of arguing with them here. Let's go save Selbart first. No, I can't get a book? That's no good. So it is blocked off. So I was supposed to go here before going to the cave with the spirits, with the elemental spirits. I was supposed to go here before that. That's a bummer. Alright. So it's going to be another book I'm putting up that I'm going to say I did not find this during my playthrough. Yeah, that's a bummer. I heard Trails of the Sky is like that as well. Some books you can easily miss. And I don't like that. Books should be readily available at all times. Reading is fundamental. I don't want to run into you. I am trying not to. Alright, let's blow off steam here, I guess. Let's see if there's a new, scenario for us to fight our way through. Hi. Alright, well, I've done all these. I did the Nephthys Shrine, Eden Shrine, Scotia. Okay. No new scenarios, then. Do you want a new encounter? No. Right, that brings the friends and... yeah, never mind then. Really is a bummer because now we don't get to see what the place looked like before the Numerous Army came in, right? I mean, maybe afterwards. Once they've been routed, I'm assuming would happen eventually. I don't know where to go. So, wait a second, we came from the screen here, so... huh? How do I leave this screen? I do not want to fight you. I'm trying to get out of here. This is confusing to me. Do I go... Wait. Oh. Through here. Okay. I couldn't tell that was a way to go. Wait. I don't think that's right. Is it? Oh, wait. Alright. Disappointing. Yeah, I remember that too. That episode was like, oh, it lets us go to Enid, even though we're supposed to be going to the cave. Should have gone there. I mean, I could restore a save and just go down there, but... aside from me reading the book, that's content you guys are not going to see, and I apologize for that. Even following a walkthrough to find the books, it's still... I missed two already. Una says, I'm worried about the people of Selbart. What's the deal with the numerous army? Ada says, I've heard from the people of Selbart that they were attacked before, too. I wonder if it was also the deed of the numerous army. When I think of what happened in Cavaro, I don't feel good about this, says Forte. Right, says McBean. I think it's reasonable to think that they've started afresh with a clean slate. I just can't imagine that they came back to occupy this desert area. They might have detected the existence of the Resonance Stone. Anyway, let's hurry on our way, says Forte. Yeah, I'm about to say that's what Fred usually says, but I don't think he's talking about what Forte said. But this is not good. I couldn't even predict that. Because at first I thought he was saying that he could not predict that Forte would say his famous line, let's hurry on our way. Alright, let's make sure I'm not missing any chests hanging up on the sides. Can we walk through there now? Evidently, I've been this way. So we've been to Selbart before. Getting all these... looks like he wanted to fight. But I did run into him. Only three this time. Let's get the sand tart. I'll use Forte's special move. Jump rush! Bloop. worth it, yeah. Now I forgot if we were going... Were we going north or south? Hold on. Selbart. Okay. Yeah, we've been here before. Fred says, what a destruction they've caused. Tuh, not good. I might have to use my trump card. A trump card, says Forte. I'll count on you, pigeon, says Fred. What? He released a pigeon? What? Sending a message? What was that, says Ada. A carrier pigeon, Una says. Where did you send it to? Where? To the sky. It's not the time to make a joke, says McBean. We gotta go save the villagers. Yes, but we don't know what his message he's sending off. Well, I guess we don't need to save him. Yeah, I've been here before. Oh, I remember now. It's the one with all the caves and the ladders and stuff. Looks like everybody's hiding somewhere. He seems fine. She's not gonna say anything. Can we walk to the other side of the counter now? Oh. Fred says, look, the numerous soldiers are in the chief's house. Uh-huh. This must be the chief's house, says one of the soldiers. Wait, says Argus, you're the ones who attacked the village the other day. Hehehe, bingo! Kachua says, what are you going to do with an old woman? It's obvious. Catch her and keep her as hostage. Sorry, but it's not gonna happen, says Argus. Yeah, get him. Ah? Oh, crap. Ugh. He fell right off there. Kachua says, Argus. Ha 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 ha, soldier laughing. Don't even think you can defeat the wooden soldiers. Siddall says, don't be so sure. Mr. Siddall, says Kachua. Chief Odessa says, I'm here too. You've got some nerve to attack Selbart. Don't even think you could go home in one piece. I'll teach you that you'll need a lot of guts and have to pay a heavy price if you challenge us. Damn you, says the soldier. McBean says, Chief Odessa. Oh, Forte, Mr. McBean. We'll give you a hand, too, says Forte. We'll take on these guys, says the chief. You go to the chapel. Looks like the main unit of the numerous army has been heading there. Gotcha, says McBean. Oomph, they're taking us too lightly, says the soldier. Let's make them regret it. Charge! Go, says Siddall. That's funny. Huh? Says the soldier. Soldier says, monster! Watch your mouth, says Siddall. I don't need you to tell me that. Everyone, let's launch a sandwich maneuver. Woo! Say the villagers. What? I gotta see the sandwich maneuver. What's the sandwich maneuver? Okay, Grandpa, let's let them take care of things here and we can go to the chapel. No, I want to see the sandwich maneuver. We're all right, says Tam. Sidol is strong as an ox. Carrion says, I'm worried about the chapel. We can handle things here, so you take care of things over there. All right. But you gotta show me the sandwich maneuver. This is probably empty. Yep. Yeah, I know where we're supposed to go. Yeah, let's just go there. I remember this place now. I was like, I can't move. Rumbling! Bow wow! Squeak! What's going on? Says Forte. What's that shaking? Earthquake? Says Una. Forte, I'm scared. Oh no, says Ada. I hate earthquakes. It's getting boring. I can't move. I'm just vibrating. Okay, already. Just like real life, you gotta wait till it's over. I wonder what that is, though. Una, it's over, says Forte. I think she noticed. She can feel things. Una says, whew, good grief. Ada says, I can't stand up. Says Fred. I bit my tongue. What have the dogs of Numeros done? Says McBean. Oh, one way to find out. Let's save because there's some cutscenes and stuff. Always be good to not have to play through them again. So. Right, there's Selbart. We were in Selbart there, and then we went to the lava cave. And then here's Oasis. And here's the new Oasis. So if I restore this Oasis, I might be able to get that book. I have to make sure to do that before I go around in the lineup of saves. And once we go back and find the save that we don't want to save over. I don't know what I'm trying to say. You guys know what I mean. I have to get the book before I save over that, which should involve me going through all the saves in turn until we get down to that one again. So, I think I'll have time. McBain says, no way! The chapel's gone, says Ada. Is it? Hey, look, says Fred. What's that? A wood soldier? No, five wood soldiers. No, behind it. Isn't that the chap? Oh! That's the Dark Sun, says Forte. What did they do? Lift up the dungeon floor to ground level? Why, says Una. Did the underground temple raise up from the ground somehow? That's another way of saying it. McBain says, so this was the cause of the earthquake. You guys can't be messing with that. It's very bad. Concentrated evil. Dang! Gotta hurry, says Fred. You're in our way, says Ada. Oh. But she was yelling at Fred. Wooden soldier encountered. Alright, let's go for the middle one, D. Do a McBain interrupt. Damn, they're tough. Four hits to take that down. So we want to hit that one next. Whatever that is, B, I guess? Oh no, that's B. We need to hit C. Hit C with everything you got. Now we're hitting all different ones. Let's get A next. Let's see. Big cure for Forte. Still kicking. Ouch. All right, let's hit E. She's just gonna do this all heal, because we all need to be healed except for Forte. McBain also hitting E, and Jan and Rick. Healing Una. So she can stay alive to do the mask cure. She hits it after people are ready it. Get hit again. No. They're only healing two of them now. You're doomed, buddy. Ups. McBain hitting 29 and Una, Forte, Jan and Rick. Still gonna save after that fight. Very ominous music playing. Yeah, keep going. Oh my god, look at that. They really did. They did raise it up from the floor. You guys shouldn't be messing around with this stuff. It's very dangerous. Don't you all into hermit crabs. McBain says, don't touch it. Oh, Commander Xenon. Who the heck are you? Necros says, look who's here, the McBain Company. Ada says, you're the old man who kidnapped Capuri. And here is a granddaughter of Rosette's workshop. I don't know if that's the voice I was using for him, but it is now. Hehehe, what a coincidence. Where is Capuri? The wood soldier is. Capuri is a doll. He's not a wood soldier. Don't mix the two together. Most likely he's been taken apart in my country. What? If that's true, I won't let you get away with it. The McBain Company, did you say? They're the ones who stole Arya from us, aren't they? That's not a nice thing to say, says Forte. We merely saved her from some bad people. Because of you, Arya escaped, and the operation to invade Marcheros failed. I'll pay you back for this. Why? Says Forte. You're repaying our kindness with resentment. Don't lay a hand on the ruins anymore, says McBain. If you seek for profits, you need to learn when to stop evil deeds. If the world is destroyed, you'll lose everything anyway. Now that the invasion failed, I can't go back to the Emperor empty-handed. I need to bring something else home to replace the Cavaro occupation. Necros, remove the seal.
As you wish.
Don't just stand there and watch him. Stop it, says Warden. Don't interrupt me. Yeah, we'll just hang out and just watch you. The fireworks. The world be destroyed. Yeah. I can't move or do anything. Okay. Ada says, ah. You say, ah. The seal, says Forte. It's been removed, says Una. He just said remove the seal. Why are you surprised? Did you stand by and do nothing and the seal has been removed? Fool, says McBain. Nothing is happening. What the hell? Wow, what's going on? Now you guys did it. You messed up real bad.
Yeah, what's this wave motion?
Wow! Help! Forte says, here, too. I can't get any closer unless we do something about it, says Fred. Aye! Says Una. She looks happy, though. Una! Ada! Says Forte. McBain says, wow! Grandpa! Fred! We're just gonna stay here and get blasted forever? Ugh! Says Forte. Gotta stop them. Oh, it's what's her name? The girl from the lake, who I know her name but can't remember it at this point. Aria, that's right. Glad I made it. Aria, why are you here? Says Forte. Una says, Aria. What'd she do? Turn around? I can't see.
Looks like she used up all her power. At any rate, what a power she possesses to seal that off.
Don't get any closer to Aria, says Forte. Don't you move one step, says Commander Xenon. Unless he wants her neck broken. Coward, says Ada. Play fair without taking a hostage. Why are you doing this, says Una. She saved you. I don't remember asking her to save me. What timing. The souvenir for the Emperor has just returned. Necros, proceed to move the Dark Sun.
Right away.
Let's stand there and watch him. Let's just fight everybody. It turned out pretty good, says Xena. The diva we let slip in Cavaro in the Dark Sun. I'm sure Emperor Rousen will be very pleased with them. Let's head back. Listen, everyone. You come back along with them after burning down the entire village. Oh, jeez. Oh, says Forte. He ran away using a spell again, says McBain. Now we're gonna fight these soldiers. Shut up and walk. What's our plan, Grandpa? There's still room to counterattack. But I'm worried about Chief and the other villagers. Let's wait for a better chance to act. Fine, fine. We'll play along for now. but I don't have to like it, mister. Chief Odessa says, wait. What? Says the soldier. I'll never allow you to be rude to my guests, she says. Chief, says Forte. Oh, I got them on this side. Kachua says, I came to save you. Una says, Kachua. The warrior Sidol says, are you ready to pay for what you've done to our sacred place? Sidol gave a fierce look to the soldiers of Numeros. Yeah, says the soldier. Let's get out of here. Ah, they just leave. Forte says, they're so quick at running away. Chief says, glad we cleared the Numeros soldiers. McBain says, I'm sorry. Dark Sun was stolen. The chief says, at least you managed to stop it from going out of control. Well done. Anyway, I thought I just heard someone singing. It was Arya of Shulf who was singing, correct? Arya was also kidnapped, says Una. Really? That's bad news, says the chief. Oh, here we go again, another earthquake. Not again, says Ada. The ceiling power has lost its control because the Dark Sun is gone, says the chief. That means what? Wow, again, says Forte. Does it mean you have to leave this village? Is it going to be swallowed up by the earth? I mean, they probably destabilized the earth by digging that up. I mean, I don't know how far it reaches. It could have reached underneath the town. And now that, you know, there's nothing to support the town from falling into the dungeon. Or where the dungeon used to be. The chief says, we don't know what's going to happen if we leave it like this. I will mobilize the power of the Shanun tribe and try to control the temple. Mr. McBain, would you be able to deal with Arya and the Dark Sun? I know it's something we have to take care of, but... Chief, we've been involved with the Water Tribe for quite a while now. It all started with the Resonant Stones. Besides, we are partially to blame for losing the Dark Sun. Forte says, besides, Arya has encountered danger so many times to save people she doesn't know. And again this time. McBain says, we'll go by our own will, without being asked. Thank you. Well, it's too late. You already were asked. Chief, please take care of yourself and be safe, says Una. You too, says the chief. And they're just leaving us. Okay. Good, let's go get Commander Xenon, says McBain. Fred says that they are to return to Numeros by boat from the port of Enid. Return to Numeros by boat. Alright. Anyway, let's go to Enid in a hurry. Alright, so this is when we actually go to Enid. Oh. Ada says, we are finally here at the Oasis. Do you think we're catching up, says Forte. Have they already passed to the Oasis, says Una. Fred says, since they fully accomplished their purpose, I doubt that they will stick around for long. McBain says, furthermore, they have Miss Arya with them. They may have gone straight to Enid without stopping off at the Oasis. Gotta hurry then, says Ada. If we don't catch them at the port of Enid, we're gonna let them slip by again. Alright, let's talk to everyone here.